Hello everyone, we welcome you to Edge Dental PG, stands for Everyday Generating Excellence. The purpose of the making video is to reach out for the maximum number of students who are preparing themselves for MDS entrance exam. The idea is we will keep a single MCQ daily for the discussion and there will be weekly answers discussed on the video. This week, we are discussing MCQs from the subject oral pathology. MCQs are framed by our experts in the subject. Moving ahead with the first MCQ, the most common craniofacial anomalies seen at the birth. The correct answer is cleft lip and cleft palate. There is also increased risk for the cleft lip and cleft palate in the children in case of the folic acid deficiency to the pregnant woman. Moving ahead with second MCQ, after intraoral mucosal nevus dash, this is the second most common to found in the oral cavity. The nevus is seen because of the collection of the melanocyte. The correct answer is blue nevus. Moving ahead with the third MCQ, a dash fold elevated risk of developing cancer exists in a Peutz-Jeghers syndrome over the general population. The correct answer is there is 15% fold elevated risk for development of the cancer exists in the Peutz-Jeghers syndrome. The Peutz-Jeghers syndrome, you have perioral and intraoral pigmentation. The perioral pigmentation fades and intraoral pigmentation persists. There is also the polyposis of the small intestine which has tendency for the malignant transformation in case of Peutz-Jeghers syndrome. Moving ahead with the next MCQ, Merkel-Cell-Rosenthal syndrome is. It is a recurrent lip or facial swelling, intermittent facial nerve palsy and fissured tongue. Merkel-Cell-Rosenthal syndrome is also called as Keelitis granulomatosa and Mischer's Merkel-Cell-Rosenthal syndrome. Moving ahead with the next MCQ, Teacher's Collins syndrome is. Teacher's Collins syndrome is a genetic disease which shows autosomal dominant inheritance in its transmission, the other name for mandibulofacial dysostosis. Moving ahead with the next MCQ, that is Hex disease. Hex disease is one of the most contagious of the oral papillary lesions, is focal epithelial hypoplasia, nothing but a Hex disease. It is also HPV induced epithelial proliferation. Coming to the last MCU, that is Keelitis granularis, that is the highest association with dysplasia is. It is a Bell's disease. Keelitis glandularis, also known as actinic keelitis. Most significantly, the susceptibility to the actinic damage is increased. Therefore, Keelitis glandularis can be considered as a potential predisposing factor for the development of actinic keelitis and squamous cell carcinoma. Thank you very much for the patient listening. We welcome you at Edge Dental PG. We are also coming with online subject-wise and mock exams as HOTP, that is online test preparation for those who are preparing themselves for MDS entrance exam. You can follow us at our website, that is www.edgedentalpg.com. You can follow us on WhatsApp and also on the Facebook. Thank you very much.